See students, today we are going to learn about side congruency rule. That is theorem 7.4. We have to learn about side congruency rule. What is the statement given here? In two triangles, if the three sides of one triangle are respectively equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. See statement here? SSS congruence rule, in two triangles, if the three sides of one triangle are respectively equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. See here, for example, in these two triangles, triangle PQR and triangle XYZ, all three sides of triangle PQR are equal to the corresponding three sides of triangle XYZ, then we have to prove these two triangles are congruent. See here, what is given here, in triangle PQR and triangle XYZ are such that PQ equal to XY, see here, side PQ equal to side XY, and QR equal to YZ, side QR equal to side YZ, and PR equal to XZ, PR equal to XZ. Then what will we have required to prove here? Triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ. For this proof, we have to construct some. Draw YW such that angle ZYW equal to angle PQR. We have to construct YW. We have to draw YW lines segment YW such that angle ZYW equal to angle PQR. Angle ZYW equal to angle PQR and WY equal to PQ. And WY equal to PQ, join XW and WZ. Right. After construction, this triangle change it to this one. Here, see here, in proof, in triangle PQR and WYZ, PQR and WYZ, this is the triangle PQR and this triangle is triangle WYZ. In these two triangles, triangle PQR and triangle WYZ, in these two triangles, we have PQ equal to WY. Why? From construction, we have to draw PQ equal to WY. Therefore, PQ equal to WY. QR equal to YZ, which is given in the statement. QR equal to YZ. Also, angle PQR equal to angle WYZ. Angle PQR equal to angle WYZ. This is from construction. From these three, in two triangles, given two triangles, by SSS rule, we have triangle PQR is congruent to triangle WYZ. Triangle PQR is congruent to triangle WYZ. These two triangles are congruent. Right. From the rules which we studied earlier, if two triangles are congruent, then all six equalities are holding. Three equalities are here, remaining three we have to write down. That means angle P equal to angle W. Angle P equal to angle W by CPCP. Also PR equal to WZ. Also PQ equal to WY. PQ equal to WY. See here, if PR equal to WZ, what is given in statement? PR equal to XZ. That means PR equal to WZ, that means equal to XZ. And that means WZ equal to XZ. Also, PQ equal to WY from CPCP. PQ equal to WY, but given statement, PQ equal to XY. That means PQ equal to WY equal to XY. From these two statements, what we have, if WZ equal to XZ, if WZ equal to XZ, this is WZ and this is XZ. What do you say about these two angles? The angles opposite to equal sides are equal. These two angles are opposite to equal sides, XZ and WZ. Therefore, these two angles are equal. So, angle WSZ equal to angle XWZ. Angle WSZ equal to angle XWZ. These two angles are equal. This is first. Take it as 1. Now, see here, PQ equal to XY. From PQ equal to XY, PQ equal to XY. That means WY equal to XY. WY equal to XY. These two sides are also equal. These two sides are also equal. That means these two angles are equal. This angle and this angle are equal. Therefore, these two angles are WXY equal to XWY. These two angles are also equal. If we add these two, angle WXZ plus angle WXY, if we add these two angles, the sum of this angle, that means angle at X equal to angle at W. That means angle X equal to angle W. See here, angle X equal to angle W. Now, from this, angle P equal to angle W. Angle P equal to angle W. See these two statements here. Angle X equal to angle W. And here, angle P equal to angle W. From these two statements, angle X equal to angle W and angle P equal to angle W, from these two statements, we have angle X equal to angle P. Angle X and angle P are equal. That means, in two triangles, PQR and XYZ, we have angle P equal to angle X, and in the statement, we have PQ equal to XY and PR equal to XZ, and this is included angle. Therefore, triangle PQR is congruent to triangle XYZ. From this proof, we have if three sides of one triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, then we can say that the given two triangles are congruent. See children, now we are going to learn about right angle, hypotenuse, side, congruency rule. That means right angle, hypotenuse, side, which is abbreviated as RHS. RHS means, in RHS, R stands for right angle. In RHS congruence rule, R stands for right angle, H stands for hypotenuse, and S stands for side. See here, right angle, hypotenuse, side. See statement once again. In two right angle triangles, the hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. So, let us prove the given statement here. See here, we have to take two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle DEF here. This is triangle ABC and this is triangle DEF. In triangles ABC and DEF, side BC equal to side EF and side AC equal to side DEF. Also, angle at B is a right angle. Angle at E is also right angle. See here, what is given in the statement? In triangles ABC and DEF, in which angle B equal to angle E equal to 90 degrees. These two angles are right angles. Therefore, given and triangles are right angle triangles. So, angle B equal to angle E equal to 90, and the hypotenuse in triangle ABC, that is AC, equal to the hypotenuse in triangle DF, DF is equal. AC equal to DF and one side BC equal to EF. What is required to prove here? Required to prove is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. See students, once again the statement, the RHS congruency rule. What is the RHS congruency rule? In two right angled triangles, if hypotenuse and one side of one triangle are equal to the hypotenuse and one side of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. See here, here we have take two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle DEF. These two triangles are right angled triangles because here in triangle ABC, angle at B is a right angle. In DEF, angle at B is a right angle. Therefore, ABC and DEF are right angled triangles. See here, given in triangle ABC and DEF are right angled triangles in which angle B equal to angle E equal to 90 degrees and AC equal to DF. AC and DF are hypotenuse of given two triangles. AC equal to DF and BC equal to EF. BC and EF are sides of given two triangles. So, in two triangles, one side and hypotenuse of one triangle are equal to the one side and hypotenuse of the other triangle. Then we have to prove triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. For this proof, we have to produce DE to G. See here, the side DE is produced to G such that EG equal to AB. How we can produce DE? How we can produce DE such that AB equal to EG? Join GF. Now we have another triangle. The triangle is triangle GEF. So proof: in triangles ABC and GEF, we have in triangles ABC and GEF, this is triangle ABC and this triangle is GEF. In these two triangles, we already have BC equal to EF, which is given in the statement. BC equal to EF, this is already given in the statement. Also, angle at B is a right angle. See here, this angle is also right angle. Because this is a straight line, the angle, the sum of these two angles is 180. Because this is a right angle, this is also a right angle. So angle E equal to angle E also 90 degrees. Therefore, angle B equal to angle E equal to 90 degrees. Also, we have from construction AB equal to G. AB equal to G. This is our construction. AB equal to G. By SAS congruence rule, for these two sides, this is included angle. For these two sides, this is included angle. By SAS congruence rule, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle GEF. Triangle ABC is congruent to triangle GEF. That means by CPCT, we have angle at A equal to angle at G. Angle A equal to angle G. Also, AC equal to GF. Side AC equal to side GF. But AC equal to DF is given in the statement. AC equal to DF is given. AC equal to DF is given. From these two statements we have GF equal to DF. From these two statements we have GF equal to DF. That means angle G equal to angle D. Why angle G equal to angle D? Since GF equal to DF, these two sides are equal. Because these two sides are equal, these two angles are equal because the angles opposite to the equal sides are equal. Therefore, angle G equal to angle D. From this, we have angle A equal to angle G and angle G equal to angle D. From what we have angle A equal to angle D. Angle A and angle D are both are equal angles. Now see here, in one triangle, two angles and one side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and one side of another triangle. By AAS congruence rule, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle BAR. Here, RHS congruence rule is proved. So, today we have learned two more congruence rules. We already know SAS congruence rule and ASA congruence rule. Today we have learned two more congruence rules, that are SSS congruence rule, that means side congruence rule, also RHS congruence rule. What is RHS congruence rule here? Right angle, hypotenuse, side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding right angle, hypotenuse, side, then the two triangles are congruent. This is RHS congruence rule. See students, from the above congruence rules, we have to solve some problems which are given in exercise 7.3. See, first question, exercise 7.3, what is given the question here? AD is an altitude. AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC. Isosceles triangle ABC. That means triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB equal to AC. AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC in which AB equal to AC. Then show that AD bisects BC. AD bisects BC. That means we have to show BD equal to DC. We have to show BD equal to DC. Also, second, AD bisects angle A. That means angle BAD equal to angle CAD. Angle BAD equal to angle CAD. Right? See here. Solution. See for solution. What is given here? See once. AD is an altitude. AD is an altitude of triangle ABC. Because AD is an altitude, the angle at D is a right angle. Given that AD is an altitude of triangle ABC, angle ADB equal to angle ADC equal to 90 degrees. Because AD is a altitude. Angle ADB equal to angle ADC equal to 90 degrees. See here, from this altitude, we have two triangles here. The two triangles are triangle ADB and triangle ADC. In triangles ADB and ADC, we have, see here, angle ADB equal to angle ADC equal to 90 degrees. From the above, that means these two triangles are right angle triangles, right? means AB and AC are hypotenuse of triangle ADB and triangle ADC. Given AD equal to AD, common side. This side is common side for both the triangles. AD is a common side. See here, which congruence rule applies here? Right angle, hypotenuse, side of one triangle are equal to the right angle, hypotenuse, side of the another triangle. Therefore, by RHS congruence rule, RHS congruence rule, we have triangle ABD is a congruent to triangle ACD. That means triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. That means by CPCT we have, by CPCT other three equalities are also holds. What are the other three equalities here? BD equal to CD. BD equal to CD. That means AD bisects angle side BC. AD bisects side BC. Which we have to prove first bit. Therefore, AD bisects BC. Since BD equal to CD, AD bisects BC. See here, one angle is given here. Angle at D is equal. Also, angle at A also equal in both the triangles. So, angle BAD equal to angle BAD equal to angle CAD. These two angles are also equal. So, angle at A in triangle ABD, angle at A in triangle ACD, both the angles are equal. Because of that, AD bisects angle A. Therefore, AD bisects angle A. See, what is the second problem given in exercise 7.3? The problem given is two sides AB, BC and median AM of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to two sides PQ and QR and median PN of triangle PQR. Then show that triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. Second one is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. See here, what is given? Median AM, median PN. What is the meaning of median? Median means the midpoint of one side is joined to the opposite vertex is called as the median of the triangle. See here. Here given median AM, also in triangle PQR median PN. What is median here? The median is the line segment which joins the midpoint of one side and opposite vertex. That is called median of the triangle. Therefore, since AM is a median, BM is equal to half BC. BM equal to half BC. Also, PN, QN equal to half QR. QN equal to half QR. That means BM equal to CM equal to half BC. QN equal to NR equal to half QR. Right? See here, what is given in the statement? Two sides AB and BC and median AM of one triangle ABC are respectively equal to two sides PQ and QR and median PN of triangle PQR. See here, write down here. Given statement is in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, we have AB equal to BC equal to QR. BC equal to QR. Also, AM equal to PN. AM equal to PN. This is given in the statement. Then we have to prove first one and second one. Solution. How to solve this problem? See here. We have to take two triangles. Consider two triangles. Triangle ABM and triangle BQL. Consider triangle ABM and triangle PQN. In these two triangles, AB and PQ are equal. AB equal to PQ and BM equal to QN. BM equal to QN. Why BM equal to QN? Are equal because BC equal to QR. Because BC equal to QR, half BC equal to half QR. Since BC equal to QR, half BC equal to half QR. Therefore, BM equal to QN. Also, we have AM equal to PN. Also, we have AM equal to PN. So, see here, in ABM, the three sides are equal to the corresponding three sides of the another triangle. By SSS congruence rule, triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN. Triangle ABM is congruent to triangle PQN, which we have to show in first bit. Right? We have proved that one. Now from this, by CPCT, what we have to write? Angle at B equal to angle at Q. So, angle B equal to angle Q. Right? This is one. Now see here, in triangles ABC and to show triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, see here, what is given? AB equal to PQ, this is given, AB equal to PQ, and BC equal to QR, this is also given, and from one we have angle B equal to angle Q. That means this is AB equal to PQ and BC equal to QR is given. This is from one. By SAS congruence rule, we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR, which we have to prove second bit. From this observation, you have to solve some more questions which are given in the textbook. See here, what is given in third question in, what is given here, third question in exercise 7.3, BA and CF are two equal altitudes of a triangle ABC. Using RHS congruence rule, prove that triangle ABC is isosceles. To solve this question, see figure once here. Triangle ECB and triangle FBC. Consider two triangles. Triangle ECB and triangle FBC. and a triangle FBC. FBC. In these two triangles, given that BA and CF are equal, BA and CF are equal because BA and CF are two equal altitudes, which is given in the question. We have BA equal to CF. BA equal to CF. BA equal to CF. And this is side of the triangle. For these two triangles, this is one side of the triangle. Also, angle at E equal to angle at F equal to 90 degrees. These two angles are right angles because BE and CF are altitudes of triangle ABC, and E and angle F is 90 degrees, right angles. And now see, BC is the common side for both the triangles. BC equal to BC. This is a hypotenuse for the both the triangle. Therefore, BC equal to BC, hypotenuse for both the triangles. This is the side. This is the right angle. Therefore, from RHS congruence rule, RHS congruence rule, we have what we have here? Triangle ECB is a congruent to triangle FBC. See here once, BE equal to CF and angle at E equal to angle at F, BC equal to BC. So the letters order is correct. Now by simplicity, what will we have? See here, by RHS congruence rule, we have triangle ECB is congruent to triangle FBC. By simplicity, we can write angle ECB equal to angle FBC, angle ECB equal to angle FBC. Angle ECB means angle ACB. Angle ECB means angle ACB and ECB, both angles are equal. Therefore, angle ECB equal to angle FBC means angle ABC. Angle ABC. Angle FBC means angle ABC. Therefore, angle at C equal to angle at B in triangle ABC. Since angle B equal to angle C, AB equal to AC. AB equal to AC. Since sides opposite to the equal angles are equal. Sides opposite to the equal angles are equal. Since in triangle ABC, AB equal to AC, triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. See here, because ECB, triangle ECB is congruent to triangle FBC, and ECB equal to angle FBC. Angle ECB means ACB. Angle FBC means ABC. Therefore, angle ACB equal to angle ABC, angle B equal to angle C. Since angle B equal to angle C, the sides opposite to the equal angles are equal. Therefore, AB equal to AC. From that observation, we have triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. See here, in exercise 7.3, see fifth question. What is given in fifth question? See once. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB equal to AC. This is triangle is ABC triangle. In ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB equal to AC. sine BA is produced to D such that AD equal to AD. Sine BA is produced to D such that BA equal to AD, AB equal to AD. Right? From this, AB and AD are equal. Since AB and AC are equal, and AB and AD are equal, AC and AD are also equal. From this, we have to show angle BCD is a right angle. This is angle BCD. We have to show angle BCD is a right angle. See here, what is given here? Solution. What is given in the question? In triangle ABC, side AB equal to AC. Right? Side AB equal to AC. Since AB and AC sides are equal, angle at B equal to angle at C. Is it correct or not? From theorem 7.2, we have the angles opposite to the equal sides are equal. Therefore, angle at B equal to angle at C. Therefore, what is angle at B? Angle ABC equal to angle ACB equal to XC. Because these two angles are equal, why these two angles are equal? Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. For that reason, angle ABC equal to angle ACD. We have to let the angle is X. So, this is X and this is also X degrees. Right? Consider this angle, angle DAC, angle DAC, exterior angle, angle DAC equal to exterior angle of a triangle is equal to sum of the opposite interior angles. Therefore, angle BAC equal to angle ABC plus angle ACB. That means angle BAC equal to X plus X, that is 2X degrees. Therefore, this angle must be 2X. Also, in triangle DAC or in triangle ADC, in triangle ADC, sides AC and AD are, side AC equal to AB and AB is equal to AD, we have AC equal to AD. Therefore, let the angle at D and angle at C, AC equal to AD. Therefore, angle ADC equal to angle ACD equal to YC. Say these two angles are Y. This is also Y. But ADC and ACD are equal. Assume the angle is Y degrees. Because angles opposite to equal angles, equal sides are equal. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Angle ADC and angle ACD are equal. Let the angle is Y degrees. Therefore, angle ADC is Y degrees. Also, angle ACD is also Y degrees. Now, exterior angle, angle BAC equal to angle ADC plus angle ACD. Exterior angle BAC equal to Y plus Y, that is 2Y degrees. Therefore, exterior angle angle BAC equal to 2y degrees. From these two, we have BC is 2y degrees. See here, what is the sum of these two angles? Angle BAC plus angle BAC equal to 180 degrees because these two are linear pair. Linear pair, angle BAC plus angle BAC equal to 180 degrees. That means 2x plus 2y equal to 180 degrees. That means x plus y equal to 90 degrees. What is x plus y here? See, what is x plus y here? X plus y is angle BCD. Therefore, angle BCD equal to x plus 5. From figure, angle BCD equal to x plus y. That means angle BCD equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, angle BCD is a right angle. Angle BCD is a right angle. See children, from this problems, you have to solve remaining problems which are given in exercise 7.3. Thank you.